Hello everyone, this is Srinidhi from Dr. MJA University second year BTech CSE. I am going to explain about normalization. Normalization is a process of organizing the data in the database. Normalization is used to minimize the recurrency from a relation or a set of relations. It is also used to estimate the undesirable characters like insertion, update, and deletion anomies. Normalization divides the larger table into smaller table and links them using relationship. The normal form is used to reduce the recurrency from the database table. There are four types of normal forms. They are first normal form 1NF, second normal form 2NF, third normal form 3NF, fourth normal form or Boyce-Codd normal form BCNF. Normal forms and their descriptions. First normal form. A relation is in 1NF if it is contained an atomic value. Second normal form. A relation will be in 2NF if it is 1NF and all non-key attributes are full functional dependent on the primary key. Third NF. A relation will be the 3NF if it is 2NF and no transition dependency exists. 4NF. A relation will be 4NF if it is Boyce-Codd normal form and has no multiplicative value dependency. Now, we will see this explanation of each normal form. First normal form. A relation will be 1NF if it is contained an atomic value. It states that an attribute of a table cannot hold multiple values. It must hold only one single value attribute. First normal forms disallows the multiple value attribute, composed attribute and their combinations. Now, we will see the 1NF through an example. Example, relation employee is not in 1NF because multiple value attributes employee phone. If you see in employee phone, we have two numbers in employee ID 14, but we should have one number in employee ID 14. So, we are going to do decomposition to the employee table. Similarly, in employee ID 12, which has also two numbers. So, now we are going to decompose the table. That is, we are going to separate the numbers. Before employee 14 has two numbers. But after the separation, 14 was written to 10s and John was written to 10s and numbers were separated. So if the numbers were separated, but if you see the employee ID, employee name and employee state was the same. So we have written same. Same like that for employee ID for 12 too. So this was the first normal form. Now we are going to see second normal form. Second normal form. In the 2NF, relation must be in 1NF. Second normal form, all non-key attributes of full functional dependency on the primary key. Now we will see 2NF through an example. Example, let us assume a school can store the data of teachers and the students they teach in a school. A teacher can teach more than one subject. So in the table consists of teacher details and teacher subject they teach. If you see, teacher ID 25 was written 2 times. So, she was teaching two subjects, it seems. Her age is 30, her ID is 25, but she is teaching two subjects, chemistry as well as biology. Same for the 83. Her ID is 83, she is teaching two subjects, which is max and computer, and her age is 38. So, in the table, in the given table, non-prime attributes, teacher ages depend on the teacher ID, which is a proper subset of a candidate key. That is why it violates the rule of 2NF. So, if we separate decompose the table, if you see 25 was written 2 times. So, one person ID is 25. So, she was taking two subjects. First table, we are going to write about the teacher detail table. So, 25 is 30, 47 is 35, 83 and 30. 83 ID is 38, her ages. Then we'll see this teacher subject table. Teacher subject table, it seems like age 25 got two, she is teaching two subjects, chemistry as well as biology. So this was written 2 times, 25 and again 25, which is chemistry and biology. Then 47 teacher ID is English she is teaching. And 83, which is max and computer. This is the decomposition of 2NF. So, we are going to see 3NF. A relation will be in 3NF if it is 2NF and not any transitive partial dependency. 3NF is used to reduce the data duplication. It is also used to achieve the data independency. If there is no transitive dependency for non-prime attributes, then the relation must be in third normal form. A relation in the third normal form, if it is hold at least one of the following conditions for every non-trivial function dependency, x tends to y. X is a super key and y is a prime attributes. That is, each element of y is a part of some candidate key. We'll see third normal form through an example. Now, in example is employee table, which consists of employee ID, employee name, employee pin code number, that's zip, employee state and employee city. If you see, the super keys in the table is employee ID, employee name and employee zip, that is pin code, employee zip. It was a super keys. This can accept that employee state and employee city is not a super key. It is a prime attributes. It is a non-prime attributes actually. Then, if you see the employee candidate key is the employee ID. By typing out the employee ID, we can came to know their name, zip key, where they are staying, from which city. So candidate key is the employee ID. So now we see in the non-prime attributes. In the given table, all attributes except employee ID are non-prime. That is, employee state and employee city depends on the employee zip. And employee zip depends on the employee ID. The non-attributes employee state and employee city transitive depends on the super key employee ID. That is, if you see employee state, employee city, which depends on the zip, which zip depends on the employee ID. So it is indirectly, that is employee state and employee city, what indirectly depends on the employee ID. So if we decompose the table, we get out the employee table, employee zip table. That is employee ID and employee name and employee zip. If we type out an employee ID, employee name and employee zip will come. So by typing out the employee city, we'll come to know the employee state and employee city. So there are two tables. We are decomposing the third normal form. So now we'll see the fourth normal form. That is boys got normal form. BCNF is advanced version of 3NF. A table is in BCNF is every functional dependency x tends to y. X is a super key of the table. For BCNF, the table should be in 3NF. And for every FD, LHS is a super key. So, now we'll see the BCNF in the example. Example, let assume there's a company where employees works in more than one department. So, there's a company where the employee works more than one department. I already said this, with an employment ID, we can came to the name, where they are staying and where their departments. They said they are working in more than one department. So, we can find out from which department. So, everything can be found out by the employee ID as well as the employee and department number. So, if you see, in the above table, functional dependency as follows. Employee ID, which gives out the employee's country, which is employee ID, employee country, which is give out. And if you see employee dependency, employee type and employee dependent number. So employee dependency means employee dependence department, which is give out the employee type and employee department number. So if you see employee ID 264 264 364 364, that means employee ID 264, which he is in India, he was doing two work, which is designing and testing. Our employee type is D394 and same thing, 3394, because he is doing two work, because that is designing and testing. But the department number is 283 and 300. So, if you decompose the 4NF, you will get the employee, we are going to write the country table first one. So, we'll get the employee is 264, 364, which is India and UK, because same thing was repeated, because 264 was doing two work, which is designing as well as testing. So, we have written one time itself, because one time it's enough, 264. So, again, Next is employee table. Employee table is about depends on employee department, employee type and employee department number. So first is designing, testing, stores, developing, four types. And for designing, testing was doing by same department type, that is D394, and same employee department number, so that is 283300. And storing, development also same like that. So if you see, now we are going to do employment department mapping table. So first we have done employee ID, second we have done employee department. So we are going to join out, that is employee ID with employee department, that is 264 was doing designing, again 264 were doing testing, then 364 were doing stores storage, then 364 again developing. So this was the overcome of the 4NF.